Om Agyan ಜ್ಞಾನಂಜನಾಸನಾಕೃಂದಲಿತ ಜೈನ ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುದೇ ನಮಃ. ಶ್ರೀ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಸ್ಥಾಪಿತ ಜೈನ ಭೂತಲೈ ಸ್ವಯಂ ರೂಪ ವಂದೇಹಂ ಶ್ರೀಗುರು ಶ್ರೀಯುತಾಪದಕಮಲಂ ಶ್ರೀಗುರು ವೈಷ್ಣವಂಶ ಶ್ರೀರೂಪಂ ಸಾಗರಾತಂ ಸಾಗರಾ ರಘುನಾಥಂ ವಿಕಂ ಸಂಸದೀವಂ ಸಾಧ್ವೈತಂ ಸಾಧುತಂ ಪರಿಜನ ಸಹಿತಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ದೇವಂ ಶ್ರೀ ರಾಧಾ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪಾದ ಸಹಗಣಾಲಯತ ವಿಶಾಖಾಂಡಿತಂ ಹೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕರುಣಾ ಸಿಂಧು ದೀನಬಂಧು ಜಗತ್ಪತೆ ಗೋಪೇಶ ಗೋಪಿಕಾ ಕಾಂತ ರಾಧಾ ಕಾಂತ ನಮಸ್ತುತೆ ತಪ್ತ ಕಾಂತನ ಗೌರಾಂಗೇ ರಾಧೇ ವೃಂದಾವನೇಶ್ವರಿ ವಿಷಭಾನಸುತಿ ಕರುಣಾಮೇಶ್ವರಿ ವಂಶಕಲ್ಪಾತ್ರಿಯಸ್ಯ ವಿಕಾಸಿಂದು ಜೈವಶ ಮಜಿತಾನಾಂ ಬಾಹುಲೇಭ್ಯೋ ವೈಷ್ಣವೇಭ್ಯೋ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ. ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂ ಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ರೆಸೈಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಭಾಗವತಂ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಪಸ್. Let us first offer our respectful obeisances unto Narayana, Supreme Personality of Godhead, unto Nara Narayanganishi, the Supermost Human Being, unto Mother Saraswati, the Goddess of Learning, and unto Sri Vyasadeva, the Author. Nasta prayasya bhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati tama shloke bhaktir bhavati naistike. By regularly hearing the Srimad Bhagavatam and by rendering a service unto the pure devotee, all that is troublesome within the heart becomes destroyed and practically familiar. And letting devotional service unto the Supreme Lord, whose praise with transcendental songs becomes established as an irrevocable fact. Idam Bhagavatam Nama Puranam Tamasamitam Tamashloka Charitam Chakara Bhagavan Rishi Nishreyasaya Lokasya Dhanyam Svasya Namaha. This Srimad Bhagavatam, known as the Granth Raj, is the king of all living literatures. It is the visual incarnation of God. It is compiled by the incarnation of God, the Sri Vyasadeva. It is meant for the ultimate good of all people. It is all successful, all blissful, and all blissful. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare
Hare Rama Hare Rama
Hare Rama Hare Rama
Rama Rama Hare Hare
Rama Rama Hare Hare
Om Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. We continue reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, canto number 3, chapter 25. Oh,
yeah.
Entitled The Glories of Devotional Service, and today is 12,
eh? 1-2,
yes. Maitreya Uvacha Iti Sva Matur Niravadyam Ipsitam Vishamya Pumsam Apavarga Vavhanam. Dhiya Abhinandya Atmavatam Satam Gatir Vabhasa Ishat Smita Chobitananaha Maitreya Uvacha. Iti sva matur niravadyam ipsitam Nishamya pumsam apavagavardhanam Dhiya binandyat mavatam satam gatir Abhasa ishat smita sobita nanaha Iti samatur niravadyam ipsitam Dishamya pumsam apavargavardhanam Dhiya binandyat Navatam satam gatir Abhasa ishat smita sovidhanana Iti samatur niravadyam ipsitam Nishamya pumsam apavargavardhanam Dhiya binandyat navatam satam gatir Abhasa ishat smita shobhitanana Maitreya Uvacha Iti samatu nivata ipsitam Nishamya pumsam papavardhanam Dhiya binandyat navatam satam gatir Abhasa ishat smita sovidhananah Maitreya Uvacha. Iti Svamatu Niravadyam Ipsitam Disham Yapum Sambhavadadhanam Yavinam Yatnavatam Satam Katiram Abhasai Satsmita Sovitanana Maitreya Uvacha Iti Samatu Niravadyam Ipsitam Disham Yapum Sambhavadadhanam Diya Vinandyatmavatam Satam Gatir Abhasai Satsmita Sobhidanana. Ladies, Maitreya Uvacha Iti Samatu Niravadyam Ipsitam Disham Yapum Sambhavadadhanam Dhiya Vinandyatmavatam Satam Gatir Babhasa Isatmita Shobhitanaha Maitreya Uvacha. Maitreya said, Iti, thus, Samatuhu of his mother, Niravadyam, uncontaminated, Ipsitam, desire, Nishamya, after hearing, Pumsam of people, Apavarga, cessation of bodily existence, Vadhanam, increasing. Dhiya, mentally, Abhinandya, having thanked, Atmavatam, interested in self-realization, Satam, of the transcendentalists, Gatihi, the path, Babhashi, he explained, Ishat, slightly, Smita, smiling, Shobita, beautiful, Ananaha, his face. Translation and purport by Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki. Maitreya said, after hearing of his mother's uncontaminated desire for transcendental realization, the Lord thanked her within himself for her question, for her questions, and thus his face smiling, he explained the path of the transcendentalists who are interested in self-realization.
My dear,
purport. Devahuti has surrendered her confession of material entanglement and her desire to gain release. Her questions of Lord Kapila are very interesting for persons who are actually trying to get liberation from material entanglement and attain the perfectional stage of human life. Unless one is interested in understanding his spiritual life or his constitutional position, and unless he also feels inconvenience in material existence, his human form of life is spoiled. One who does not care for these transcendental necessities of life and simply engages like an animal in eating, sleeping, fearing, and mating has spoiled his life. Lord Kapila was very much satisfied by his mother's questions because the answers stimulate one's desire for liberation from the conditional life of material existence. Such questions are called apavargavardhanam. Those who have actual spiritual interests are called sat or devotees. Satam prasangat. Sat means that which eternally exists, and asat means that which is not eternal. Unless one is situated on the spiritual platform, he is not sat, he is asat. The asat stands on a platform which will not exist, but anyone who stands on the spiritual platform will exist eternally. As spirit soul, everyone exists eternally, but the asat has accepted the material world as his shelter, and therefore he is full of anxiety. Asat Grahan, the incompatible situation of the spirit soul who has the false idea of enjoying matter is the cause of the souls being asat. Actually, the spirit soul is not asat. As soon as one is conscious of this fact and takes to Krishna consciousness, he becomes sat. Satam gatihi, the path of the eternal, is very interesting to persons who are after liberation, and his lordship Kapila began to speak about that path. Translation again, Maitreya said, after hearing of his mother's uncontaminated desire for transcendental realization, the Lord thanked her within himself for her questions, and thus, his face smiling, he explained the path of the transcendentalists who are interested in self-realization. Today we'll finish our class exactly at 9 because we have some so this very interesting point which is being brought out, Lord Kapila, upon hearing the, it says, uncontaminated questions, pure questions, sincere questions from his mother, became very pleased and slightly smiling began to speak about transcendental subject matters. And in the purport, Srila Prabhupada very nicely explains, emphasizes the difference between these two paths, the path of sat and asat. Asat, which means temporary, simply creates more and more anxieties and suffering for the conditioned soul. So asat means actually those who are materialistic, those who are not interested in spiritual transcendental subject matters.
Every day,
Those who are simply caught up and conditioned by the modes of material nature. So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna confirms, Mogasha Mogakarmano Mogadhyana Vichetasa Dakshasim Vasurima Chaiva Mohinim Pratim Svitaha. There are two energies, the Mohini Prakriti, or external energy, and then there is the Daivi Prakriti. Mogasa, Mogakarmano, Mogagyana. All of one's desires, all of one's activities, all of one's knowledge, when they are motivated, when they are impure, when they are simply for temporary results, they are doomed to failure. We see in modern day society, the world actually today all over, practically in every country of the world, because the leadership in different countries is not in line with what is presented in the Shastra. It is simply for so-called economic development, so-called material well-being. All of the attempts are actually resulting in failure, major failure, big failure. The whole world, as we know, as we can see, and as we can experience, is full of very deep and very very large, major, global problems, because we are following the path of asat, temporary. So therefore, devotee is someone who has understood this basic principle, that actually there is something beyond this body, there is something beyond this material world, and my main purpose in life actually is to understand, deepen my understanding of the spiritual reality of life. Otherwise, as Srila Prabhupada clearly mentions in the purport, we are otherwise spoiling our lives. Very foolishly spoiling our lives, because one does not understand that he may not so quickly, so soon again, get this opportunity of human form of life. Those who are totally materialistic, which is the majority of people in the material world, they cannot understand how gloomy their future is. They're simply blind after material pursuits, not knowing that actually the future, their future life, even though they don't believe in it, is very gloomy. Gloomy means very dark. not only the future life but also one's present life. Those who actually are not following principles as laid down in the Shastra, those who are not regulated in their eating habits, those who are not regulated in their activities of sense gratification, they are simply creating very complicated conditions for themselves. If we contradict the laws of nature either knowingly or unknowingly, we must suffer. The child doesn't know that fire burns, but even though he doesn't know he's innocent, if he puts his hand, he'll get burnt. A law of nature is very strict. If we overeat, then we have to fast the next day. Sometimes they try to take pills to alleviate. Actually, that's why in the Shastra, fasting is recommended, occasionally, fasting. Shastra is giving us all the information we need, how to live materially in this material world, and also how to develop our spiritual life. So therefore, those who are devotees, those who are Vaishnavas, they understand how this material world is very dangerous, and those who are devoid of this knowledge and understanding, their present condition and their future condition is also very precarious. So, very important point here, how Mother Devahuti, she's approaching Lord Kapila with very pertinent questions. Very often people, they will go to some sadhu, not with very good questions. Most of the time their questions are not good questions. And my daughter or my son, I need to get them married. Can you give some blessing? These are not the kind of questions we should ask sadhus. One time Srila Prabhupada was traveling in a train, and some of his senior disciples, sannyasis, were also traveling with him. And yeah. So, especially because Srila Prabhupada came with some Western devotees, and Prabhupada was an elderly gentleman, elderly sadhu. So naturally people, that is the culture in India, people want to get blessings from sadhu. So the devotees knew that they should not allow people to disturb Srila Prabhupada. They had booked one small, in the train they had this kind of, I don't know what they call it, like roomette, single room, small room. Small room, small compartment, whatever. And some of the sannyasis traveling with Prabhupada, they had some they had different matters to discuss. So they told one brahmachari outside, you stand by the gate outside and make sure nobody comes in. Somehow that brahmachari became a little inattentive, and then as soon as he was not looking, because people know who's traveling on the train, especially some sadhu, and so two or three householders, Indian gentlemen, they somehow just snuck in and then sat down in front of Prabhupada. So, of course, once people are sitting in front of sadhu, it is not polite to tell them to go. So Prabhupada asked them, yes, what can I do for you? So each one of them started to explain, Swamiji, I have to go through some very serious operation next month. Kindly give me your blessings so that it can be successful. And then the second one, he said, actually, I've waited a long time. I cannot somehow arrange for the marriage of my daughter. Please bless me so that I can find somebody to marry my daughter. So Srila Prabhupada was very patiently hearing these different requests. So in the bogi, in the compartment were like three or four sannyasis. So after hearing very patiently from these three individuals, Prabhupada looked at them, says, yes, I will give you my blessing. And he looked at them and he pointed to his sannyasi, devotees, disciples. I bless you that one day you also take saffron and become renounced. They very quickly folded their hands and walked out. This is like too heavy blessing. Even many pious people in India, other countries also people are pious, some people are pious, but generally people are pious, they're after material benefits. Especially here in India, people worship demigods. Mostly demigod worshippers, they are after different types of material benefit. So we should know, especially as devotees should understand, should know what type of questions to ask to sannyasis or to ask the senior devotees. Those questions should be mainly, primarily, actually exclusively how we can actually deepen our understanding of spiritual life so that we can advance towards our final goal and destination. So there is a great need in society today, all over the world, to actually give an opportunity to people by giving them this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. Yes. So I request all the devotees here to take advantage of the fact that somehow you have taken up to the process of spiritual life by reading and hearing from these descriptions and instructions from the Bhagavatam. We can better understand how to more easily, more quickly progress and advance in spiritual life. And it is, of course, directly connected with another important and direct instruction given by Lord Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita, Tadvidi Pranipatina, Pali Prashnena Sevaya, Upadekshanti Te Gyanam Gyanina Sattva Darshanaha. You cannot come to that point of actually realizing or understanding tattva, means the absolute truth, unless we, as Mother Devahuti, become very humble, recognize our fallen condition, our difficult position in the material world, and unless we become inquisitive, and also, these are the three things, being humble, being inquisitive, and engage nicely in devotional service. And the best way we can more quickly come to that platform is by taking shelter of the holy name and always, every day, nicely chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Krishna
Krishna,
Krishna
Hare
Hare,
Hare Rama,
Hare
Rama,
Rama
Rama,
Hare
Hare.
Jai
Kantarashana Bhagavatam ki, Jai Sri Prabhupada ki, Gaura Pinamanda.